नमस्कार, आप सभी का स्वागत है। सो टुडे वी स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ एमएस वर्ड ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज। टिल नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड वेरियस फंक्शनैलिटीज ऑफ एमएस वर्ड एंड आई होप दैट यू ऑल हैव लर्न्ड फ्रॉम दीज सेशंस एंड टेकन द एडवांटेज ऑफ दीज सेशन एंड इम्प्लीमेंटेड दीज प्रैक्टिकल इन योर डेली लाइफ। So, without wasting any time, we'll start our today's session and today we'll learn about the various shortcut keys which are applicable in MS Office. You can say it is applicable in MS Word, MS Excel, MS PowerPoint and so on. So, in MS Word, what are the various important shortcut keys that are beneficial for us to use. So this is a slide which I prepared. So here on the left side, here this is a table. It's a table here. So these are rows and these are columns. There are two columns and these all are rows. So I have taken two things. First one is keys and second is what's the purpose of that shortcut keys. So first one, the first key, that is Control plus N. So what we have to do, first we have to press Control key. After that, while holding the pressing Control key, the user has to press N. Okay, means Control plus N, so both keys has to be pressed simultaneously. So what we have to do, first we have to press Control and while holding the press on Control key, user has to press N or the respective keys for the respective purpose. Okay, so we'll take a particular document file and we'll see how it works. Okay, so first key, that is Control plus N. So what it does, it creates a new document file. So suppose you have opened an existing document file and you have to create a new document file, then user has to press Control plus N. So you can see I am opening an existing file and now I have to open a new document file. So just I will do Control plus N. I didn't do that thing like go to here and you just I have pressed Control and N. Okay, so that is the first key, that is for opening a document file, that is Control plus N. So first user has to press Control, not N, because if user will press N, so yes, it can do N Control plus, so user has to do Control plus N. The second key, that is Control plus O, that is O. So what it does, it opens an existing document. Suppose you have created a document and save it. Now you have to open an existing document for some kind of purpose. So what you will do, you will press keys Control plus O. So plus is plus means you have to press both and simultaneously. Plus is not a key, plus means you have to press Control and O keys at the same time simultaneously. So what you have to do, just you press enter, just you press Control and while holding the press on Control key, then press O. Okay, so user don't have to press plus this kind of for understanding purpose. Okay, so again suppose I want to open a particular document file, I have to open, so just I will press Control plus O. You can see now there's a we have to see which kind of document file we want to open. So here from this purpose, see various files are written here, are displayed here. So which file you want to open, and just click on that and the particular file will be opened. So that is the purpose of second key, that is Control plus O. The third key is Control plus S. What it does, it saves our document. Okay, so suppose we have opened an existing file, we are doing editing, and after editing we want to save it. So what we will do, just we will press Ctrl and S, so it will save a document file. Suppose you are right, you have opened a new document file and you are writing into it and you want to you have to save it. So when you will do Ctrl plus S, then first you have to enter the name of the document file, after it will be saved. Okay, so you can see both things. Suppose this is a already named file, hello everyone. You can see the file name of this document is hello everyone. So suppose you are writing something, okay, you have done this, and after that Ctrl plus S, so you can see there is option of here, message coming, what is saving. So that file is saved. Now, okay, you can see this file is not has a name. So means, suppose I am saving a particular, then I have to do Ctrl plus S, you can see we have to write the name of this file. Okay, so when you will finish the writing of this name, the file will be saved. Okay. So that is the difference between saving an existing file and new file. The next key is Ctrl plus Z. So what it does? It undo an action. Now what it means? Undo an action, suppose you are doing some kind of formatting or editing in a document file. So we will do by a practical part. Okay. Suppose I am changing the formatting of this title, so I want some kind of title, so I am doing the formatting like this, and okay, now what I want that earlier formatting of this title was good. Now I want to go back to the that particular formatting. So I have to undo the particular action, means which action which I have done recently I want to undo. Okay, so what I will press Ctrl plus Z. So you can see this functionality will go back, will go step one by one back. So first we will do Ctrl plus Z, it has come, then Ctrl plus Z, it has come. So you can see, and then Ctrl plus Z, you can see our main formatting of this content has occurred. Okay, so this is a Ctrl plus Z, means you are undo an action. Then next is Ctrl plus Y, that is redo an action. Redo means suppose you have doing something formatting, you have undone, and you want to go back, to go one step next, so you have to do Ctrl plus Y. Now next is Ctrl plus F. What it means? It will find a word. Suppose you want to find a word. Suppose there is a page of 1000 pages and you want to search a particular word. User want to search a particular word. So that is Ctrl plus F. So suppose this is a word and I will press Ctrl plus F. So you can see the word which I have to find. We have to write the particular word which we have to find and then press enter, and that particular word will appear. So this is Ctrl plus F. Next is Ctrl plus C. Okay, that is very means very widely used command. It copy the selected text. Okay, so suppose you want to copy some particular text, so Ctrl plus C will help in that. So like suppose I am making a document file of MS Office, and I want this particular thing should be copied to the next. So I will first have to select the text. I have selected the text, then I will do Ctrl plus C. Now it copies. Now I have to paste. Okay, so you can see for paste there is a command Ctrl plus V. So it will paste the copies text. How we have copied the text via Ctrl plus C? अब नाउ वी हैव कॉपीज द टेक्स्ट, वी हैव द कॉपीज द टेक्स्ट बाय कंट्रोल प्लस सी. नाउ वी हैव टू पेस्ट, तो फॉर पेस्टिंग वी विल यूज कंट्रोल प्लस वी. सो वेयर वी हैव टू पेस्ट, वी हैव टू पेस्ट इन दिस फाइल एंड फॉर दैट we have to put the cursor where we want to copy. So suppose here I have to copy, so then I will press control plus v. So you can see our copies text was pasted successfully. Okay, but you can observe it has copies, means this particular text will be active in this file as well as in this file, means you are copying. Okay, you are not deleting, you are putting a particular copy to the another file. Okay, so that is control C for the copying and control V for the pasting. The next is control plus X. This cuts the selected text. It cuts and pastes somewhere. Okay, so it cuts basically. Now, so we can see via practical part. Okay, suppose I am just doing the undoing via control plus Z. So it has undone. Now, what I want that particular text, this text should be deleted from here and pasted to the another file. So first I have to select this text, then I will do control plus X. So you can see text has been cut. Now I will do another file and then I will press control plus V. Okay, so that particular text which we have cut is pasted here. Now you can see only one copy of this text remains active, and that is in this file. Okay, so that is difference between cut and copy. In copy nothing has to be deleted, but in cut first it has to be deleted, then paste it. Okay, so that is control plus X. Next is control plus A. What it does, it select the entire text of document. So suppose you want to do the formatting, or you want to copy something, you have to do the whole text, a whole document, then what you have to do, just press control plus A. You can see whole text get selected. Okay, you can see the whole text get selected. Now you can do the formatting, copy, cut, whatever you want to do, it will happen. Okay, so for selecting a whole document or whole text, the command which is used, that is control plus A. The next command is control plus B. Okay, control, suppose we have to apply the bold formatting. So it is used to apply the bold formatting. Suppose that is our title. Okay, so bold formatting, bold, underline and italic formatting you can do via this options. You can see under home tab and the font group there is an option for this option is for bold formatting, this option for italic and this option for underline. So first you have to select the text, what are the various key? So suppose we have to use the bold formatting. So first we have to select the text, then we will do control plus B. You can see bold formatting is done, and in this text bold formatting appeared. I didn't do via these option, I have done via keyboard keys option. Now I want to apply italic formatting. So I have selected the text already, then I will press control plus I. You can see italic formatting is done. Now I have to apply the underline formatting to this text. So I will press control plus U. You can see this particular text has been underlined. Okay, so this is control plus B for bold formatting, control plus I for italic formatting, and control plus U for underline formatting. So there are various shortcut keys in MS Office or MS Word, but we have demonstrated some of the widely used and important shortcut keys. So hope you all learned today's session, and so that's all for today. Thank you.